G'day. Just doing a rebuild on a 4L60E in a four-wheel drive or all-wheel drive Adventra, Holden Adventra V8. And I get a lot of questions on the 4L60s, why they blow up, what you can do to improve them. Now, I'm not going to go through everything rebuilding there. There's plenty of videos and information on both YouTube and on the net. I notice that a lot of people have a lot of trouble with these transmissions. The biggest problem on these is burning out the 3-4 clutch, which has happened in this one. This one's also a fine metal factory, so I'll show you what happened or what caused that issue as well in a moment. You can see 3-4 clutch completely burnt out. Now what happens, there's a little, what's called a lube seal here. You can see that seal. And that one runs on your output shaft. It actually seals here like this. You can see that one's flobbed right out. You can see there's no tension on that rubber at all. Even if I put that in that spline section, which will push it in, sort of tighten it up a little bit, but even if I do that, working left-handed here. There can see it's like really floppy loose. Now there's not much you can do about that one apart from replace that. They have got a little lip there. I've dreamt of times where I could make a whole new aluminium piece like this and make a nice straight edge on the inside and cut a groove in here and put a little Teflon ring in there, and that would help seal that basically forever. But what happens, the lube pressure that's coming towards the back of the transmission, and you've got a series of bushes here that go right up to the rear planetary, and you can see those little ports there. So they rely on this being sealed properly, and that's why usually the rear planetary ends up blowing up. You can't see it when you actually, if I put a little bit of solvent in there, you'll see where the solvent comes out of. Now it'll lube that bush there, this one here. You can see there's a few little ports there that are supposed to help create a little bit of lubrication there. Once that lube seal goes, you lose your lube pressure there. And over here, this is actually the rear planetary setup. You've got your annulus gear, the one that goes around the planetary. You've got your planetary, which is this. You can see the teeth are completely munged out there, they're gone. And you've got the sun gear, which basically the planetary gears go around the sun gear. You can see it's chewed it right out. So that there is caused by a lack of lube pressure or no lube going back to here. So replacing those lube seals, definitely beneficial. In the old days, the 700R4s, they actually had a plastic one. I remember those days. I haven't seen one of those for quite a while. These ones are a little bit flexible, but what happens is that that little lip wears out because it's that shaft's spinning on it. I always linish them as best as I can, make it beautiful, nice and smooth, so last a little bit longer, won't chew it out. Same as any of these journals where the bushes run, and that'll make it last a lot longer than your average one, especially if you don't replace it. 240 grit to start with, 600 grit, very fine to finish it off with. bushes run on here, and you've got that lube seal runs on here. You want to have that super. And the other thing I do, if you notice in this transmission, even with that cruddy lube seal gone, the 3-4 clutch is burnt out, but all the other clutch packs look all right. See, they're still got the colour there. They might be a little bit worn. They don't look too bad. You want to make sure you always check all your bushings. A lot of people don't replace them. I don't know why. That's the bushings are the things that are keeping everything central. If they're worn, the movement, sealing rings can't take up the movement, and you end up getting internal cross leaks and pressure leaks. Now I'll show you a little secret how to fix your 3-4 clutch from burning out. You can get the Sonax kits, which have improver kits, and they tell you to remove these little springs out of there and some people say put them in. I always leave it all in. I'm not smarter than the manufacturer. But the one thing I do on these particular transmissions, and I never, hardly ever have a problem of a 3-4 clutch coming back burnt out, you'll see these sealing rings on the input shaft. Now they're a complete hole sealing ring or Teflon ring. And what you're supposed to do is actually stretch it. And then you have a shaping tool like this, and that'll just go on there and shape the sealing ring or the Teflon ring to fit snugly in here in the pump. That's where you're getting the pressure for it, applying through these ports, through those holes, and then see there's little ports between those sealing rings, 1, 2, 3. Now what happens over a period of time, these rings collapse or they get shaped to where they sit. There's nothing to expand them. If your ring bushings are worn out, it's going to actually, you know, I'm exaggerating there, but it's going to move around like that and shape those rings smaller as well. So what I do, I never use these type of rings. I use these ones. They have a little step cut in there. And guess what? The beauty of it, you don't need a shaping tool. Whenever you get pressure coming in here, it'll actually push that ring to take up any slop or wear, even if the bushes are worn. You can see that can expand all the way up to there before it stops sealing. Can you see that? You got that step, it'll go all the way to there, which would mean that they're completely buggered. So they'll never actually leak. So two main things, that's my little secret that I do in the 4L60s. I don't have these issues that you hear people having all the time. Regular service on the transmission. The idea is to replace the filter. The filters are very fine. They'll collect all that really, really fine swarf and debris in there. And also to clean the magnet. Add a magnet if you can. The cleaner you keep the oil or you keep that muck away from the solenoids, everything will operate better and longer. Another thing is, I always use a Dextron 3 in these, unless it's a racing car or something like that. Dextron 3's, the viscosity of the oil is a little bit thicker. So any internal pressure leaks you might have, it's going to take longer for thicker oil to pass through there than thinner oil. And another thing is to have a bypass oil cooler. Completely bypass the heat exchanger or the radiator. You eliminate that issue of getting coolant in the transmission fluid, and what happens, it works on the clutch linings, and it'll actually cause all these to peel off, especially in the torque converter where most of the heat is created, the torque converter clutch lining will peel and you'll get all sorts of problems. But anyway, I hope that information has helped. The band as well, you can see a little bit of metal's fallen in between the band and the drum. So the rear planetary would have failed from that lube seal, and the 3-4 clutches would have failed because of those rings. They've collapsed. The bushings are all worn out as well, so not much you can do about that. Anyway, don't forget to like and subscribe. Leave any questions, comments in the section below. Throw us a beer if any of this information helps. If you'd like to purchase some of these, you can contact me on via our Facebook link if you're in Australia. Thank you for watching.